8:52 now on your Monday, and throughout the entire month of October, we have been telling you about the Real Men Wear Pink campaign. October, Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and the campaign encourages men to help in the fight against breast cancer. So now that the month is over, the campaign has wrapped up, and we're updating you on how incredibly successful this year's campaign was. Christina Kelly is here with the American Cancer Society, and Jody Elsom, a breast cancer survivor, both with us here. Great to have you, and we did pretty well, it sounds like.
We did great. They were more engaged this year. We had about 30 men from throughout the Puget Sound. They had pink dinners, wine tastings. They were at Seahawk games. They made a goal in Seattle to raise $100,000, and they made the goal.
Yeah, that's fantastic. And one team in particular was
well, we got to give a shout out to the number one fundraiser. It's Tom Flukes. You had him on the program with the pink beard. He raised almost $59,000.
Which is one of the top fundraisers in the entire nation.
Yes, and I got to give a shout out to Tom because he and his wife Dawn went above and beyond the commitment. We had Tom Lane in Everett raised $11,000. Erwin Tijon raised $9,000. Jeremy Miner, $3,300. Trevor Coat, $3,200. And Gavin McMurdo, who was here last week with his pink hair, $3,000. So
that's awesome.
That's money that's going to go to pay for research, programs, getting patients to their treatments. If someone in Yakima has cancer and they're coming to Seattle to be treated, we'll house them at free or reduced costs. That's what this money's going for.
Right, and going for folks and like help. Jody, who is a cancer survivor. Can you talk a little bit about your experience with breast cancer and why this is so important?
Sure, yeah. I was diagnosed 5 years ago Halloween, and I had spent my career building cancer facilities for some of these large hospitals and that were designed towards helping patients through the process. I did not expect to be a patient.
Right.
So I remember that diagnosis and it just hit me like a wall. It's like, no, I can't have cancer. But I was lucky. I was caught early. And thanks to all the research that's been done, the early detection made my journey less scary, I guess. I mean, it's still scary when you hear it, but.
And I think that's, if there's one encouraging thing for us cancer survivors, it is that so much great work is being done and so much, you know, technology, research, and advances in medicine are making it possible that so many of us are able to, you know, cure rates are much higher and now we're having so many more survivors out there, which is just phenomenal.
Absolutely. Right? You know, the money that we raised in the past helped people like Jody. What we've raised today are going to help people who haven't been diagnosed yet. And so that's what we're looking for is new treatments. Hopefully someday we will stop losing our loved ones to this disease.
Oh, absolutely. And if folks want to get involved next year, you know, through the month of October, where can they head?
They can go to cancer.org or go to Real Men Wear Pink, Seattle. Start thinking about it because it's good for business. It is.
Yeah.
As the business editor was on, the Seattle Business Magazine editor was on, he said it's good for business. Mm-hmm. And it is. I will support somebody who supports breast cancer.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Christina, Jody, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And by the way, you can learn more about this year's campaign and how you can help out next year. You can go to realmenwearpinkacs.org/SeattleWA.